Good morning students, hope you all are fine. In our previous video, we were doing chapter 3 from your English grammar book, that is parts of speech, and there are total 8 parts of speech, and we have done the first part, that is noun. Today we will take pronoun, verb and adjective. Now let's start our class. Now students, first we will do our homework part which I have given you in my previous video. The question was, encircle the nouns in the following sentences and write whether they are common, proper, collective, abstract or material noun. Now see the first one. First is, gold is a precious metal. So here gold is a material noun. So you have to circle it. I am doing underline. You can do circle. So now see the second one. The Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean. Here the Pacific Ocean is a particular name of a ocean. So it is proper noun. Now is the largest ocean. Ocean is a common noun because we have many oceans. We have Pacific Ocean, we have Atlantic Ocean, we have Indian Ocean. So ocean is a general name, so it is common noun. Now see the third one. Rohan's father is a doctor. Here Rohan's is a name of a particular person, so it is proper noun. Father is common and doctor is a common noun. Now see the fourth one. This is an amazing band of musicians. Here band is a collective noun because it represents a group of musicians. So what is collective noun? Collective noun names a collection of person or things taken together as a group are called collective noun. Now see the fifth one. Our army fought with great courage. Here army is a collective noun. Courage is a abstract noun. And what are abstract noun? Abstract nouns are names that state the quality, feeling or idea, and you can only think of them. You cannot touch them. They are non-tangible. Now see the sixth one. His mother gave him a good advice. So here you can see mother is a common noun. Gave him a good advice. Advice is a abstract noun. Now see the seventh one. My teacher has both wisdom and knowledge. So here teacher is a common noun. Wisdom and knowledge are abstract noun. Now see eighth. Slumdog Millionaire is an Oscar winning movie. Here Slumdog Millionaire is a proper noun because it is a particular name of a movie. Oscar is also proper and movie is a common noun. Now see ninth. Shah Jahan built the Taj Mahal in Agra. So Shah Jahan is a particular name of a person. It is proper. Taj Mahal is a proper noun, name of a monument. Agra is a name of a city, so it is proper noun. Now see the 10th one. This room looks beautiful. So room is a common noun. Beautiful is a abstract noun. Now students, we will learn what is pronoun. In pronoun, we will learn kinds of pronoun. They are personal, reflexive, interrogative, demonstrative. So now moving to what is pronoun. A pronoun is a word that replaces a noun in a sentence. Pronouns are used to avoid repeating the same nouns over and over again. It means pronoun replaces a Now, to avoid repetition and make our speech sound more natural. So they all are pronoun. Now here is one example. Mary is in Mary's office, but Mary asked not to be interrupted. So here you can see we have used Mary almost 3 times. So there is so in pronoun, in order to avoid unnecessary repetition, we will write like this. Mary is in her office, but she asked not to be interrupted. So the sentence, both sentences are same, but in order to make the sentence more natural in speaking, we will add here her and she to avoid repetition. So you can see Mary is a noun and pronoun is her and she. So now you must have understood that pronouns eliminates the repetition and made our speech more natural. Now here are a few more examples. Look at Mike. Mike is a good boy. Mike loves to study. Mike is good at skating. So here we have used Mike many times. So instead of Mike, we can use he. Now read these sentences again. Look at Mike. He is good boy. He loves to study. He is good at skating. So now you can see the sentence is more natural in speaking and we have eliminated the word Mike. So here you can say the word he takes the place of Mike and it is called pronoun. Now there are many different types of pronoun. They are personal, possessive, reflexive, intensive, demonstrative, interrogative, relative, indefinite and reciprocal. But we will study only personal, reflexive, interrogative and demonstrative. These 4 are in your course, so we will study only these 4. Now what is personal pronouns? Personal pronouns are pronouns that refer to a specific person or thing in a sentence. Personal pronoun stands for 3 persons. First person speaking. So the words are I, we, me, us. So they are all pronoun. Example, this car belongs to us. Now see the second person. Person spoken to, you, to, the. Example, only you are allowed to attend the party. Third person, person spoken of. Then the words are he, she, it, they, them, her, him. So examples are heard him telling them about the movie. So them is a pronoun here, personal pronoun. Now moving to reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns are pronouns where the subject and the object are the same persons. Reflexive pronouns are formed by using self in the singular and selves in the plural. Now you can see here are few words of reflexive pronoun. The first one is myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourself, yourself, themselves. So they all are reflexive pronouns. Here is examples. I told myself not to spend all my money on new shoes. So here myself is a pronoun, reflexive pronoun. Second example, you are going to have to drive yourself to the restaurant today. Third example, we gave ourselves plenty of extra time. They brought themselves a new car. So themselves is a pronoun, reflexive pronoun, ourselves is a reflexive pronoun, yourself reflexive pronoun, myself reflexive pronoun. Now moving to interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are used in questions. So these are those pronouns in which we ask questions. Like the questions words are like what, which, who, whom, whatever, whichever, whoever, whomever. So these all are interrogative pronouns words. Example, who told you to do that? Which dog won the race? Who is going to arrive first? Which of these do you like better? So here, who, which, who, which. These all are interrogative pronouns. They ask questions. Now, what is demonstrative pronoun? Demonstrative pronouns are used to demonstrate or indicate. It means we are indicating someone. Demonstrative pronouns take the place of a noun that is already been mentioned. It means, okay, you will understand by seeing the example. Demonstrative pronouns includes the word these, those, these, that, such. Example, those are my neighbor's dog. This is my bicycle. These are cakes and those are burgers. That is my bag. In those days, we were young and innocent. So here, words those, this, these, that, they all are demonstrating pronoun. In this second point, you can see demonstrating pronoun take the place of a noun that is already been mentioned. So here you can see an example. First example, those are my favorite neighbor's dog. Here dog is a noun. So here those is indicating, mentioning the noun which is already have been said. Now moving to adjectives. Adjectives are words before a noun that describes a noun. Here is one example. The short man walked away. So here man is a noun and adjective is short. Here it is describing the man who walked was short. Means he is describing about a noun. So short is an adjective. Now, here is definition of adjective. Adjectives are words that are used to describe or modify nouns or pronouns. Examples of adjectives are, he writes meaningless letters. Means here, meaningless is adjective. This glass is breakable. So here you are telling about the glass, that this glass is breakable. They live in a beautiful house. So here you are telling that they live in a beautiful house. You are describing about the house. The house is beautiful. So beautiful is a adjective. Now what is verb? Verb is very important. You cannot have a sentence without verb. It is very important in English because only verb has tenses. Tenses you have learned in your earlier classes also, past tense, future tense, present tense. So verb is very important. Verbs are traditionally being defined as words that shows action or state of being. Means verbs always shows the action or state. Or state means situation. Example, the monkey jumps. Jumps is a verb. Here you are telling the action of it, means you are telling the physical action of monkey, that monkey is jumps. So jumps is a verb. Now see the second, they have moved to their house. So have moved is a verb. Third example, dinosaurs lived millions of years ago. So here you are telling about dinosaur situations you are telling. So this is state. Now only I have told you that verbs tells about an action. In the first example you can see monkey, the monkey jumps. So here the physical action of monkey is telling. So this is verb, jump is a verb. Now in this last one you can see dinosaurs lived millions of years ago. So you are telling about the state, means situation. Now here is your homework question for today. Now class, your homework questions for today are, frame your own sentences using the following pronouns. You have to make a sentence by using pronouns. So the words are your, ours, mine, him, them. So you have to make a sentence. Okay, so do your homework, and if you have any doubts regarding any topic or anything, you can leave a comment below my video. I will clear your doubt. Now we will meet in our next class. Till then, bye and stay safe.